Imagine if you had a being that watched over your family. This being lives on average about 700 years. They live for 700 years and they watch over your family for 10 generations. They are incredibly wise compared to you because they've been around for so long. They seem to see things that you don't see because they can fly over your head and float in the atmosphere. Despite all their powers and advanced wisdom, they only care for your well-being. They're always looking out for you, and they looked out for your father before you, and your grandfather, and your great-grandfather. People whom you've never even met, ancestors whom you've never even met, but your father and your grandfather told you that this super being has been watching over your family for generations. And you know that this super being will be watching over your descendants for generations to come. You can't even fathom it because those generations don't exist yet. You know you'll be long gone, and the world will be completely different when those generations arrive. But this guardian of your family will still be here, will be there watching over your progeny. What does that sound like? It is not so hard to imagine because that is who you are to your dog. So it's not really hard to imagine, is it, that there is some transcendent being watching over you, watching even before you were born. Now stretch your imagination a bit and imagine that that being has another being who watches over him, who lives 7 years longer than him, and is able to fly higher than him. Just as you stand many times taller than your dog. And so we have angels that float over our heads. What if those angels had angels who floated over their heads? And on and on. How many iterations would it take to reach immortality? This is not a theological question, by the way. It's an exercise. Springboarded off a meme that I saw on the internet. How we are to our dogs, like the elves were to the humans in Tolkien's Lord of the Rings trilogy. But it is interesting to think about, isn't it? Remember again how Arthur C. Clarke said that any sufficiently advanced technology is indistinguishable from magic. Could a sufficiently advanced species be indistinguishable from angels and spirits? Just something to play about in my head.